In this video, I will discuss about Wheatstone bridge. Wheatstone bridge consists of four resistances R1, R2, R3 and R4 connected like this. A galvanometer is connected between the nodes B and D, and there is a battery of EMF E which drives the current in this circuit. Wheatstone bridge consists of four resistances R1, R2, R3 and R4. Galvanometer is connected between a pair of opposite nodes, that is nodes B and D, and cell in another pair, that is nodes A and C. Galvanometer is measuring the current in the branch in which it is connected. When the bridge is balanced, the current in the galvanometer IG is zero. In general, there will be some current flowing in this branch in which the galvanometer is connected, but the value of resistance are adjusted such that this current is zero. Then we say that the Wheatstone bridge is balanced. When that balance condition, the galvanometer is connecting the nodes B and D, so the potential at the nodes B and D should be same. In electrical circuit, if there is no current flowing between two points which are connected by a conductor, then the two points are the same potential. If the current is not flowing in this galvanometer branch, then it means that the potential at points B and D are same. Let us consider an analogous situation. Water from a tank at the top of a building which is being brought down by two pipes. So this is a water tank and there are two pipes bringing down the water. Now suppose we connect these two pipes by a third pipe like this, will the water flow in this pipe? Now if we connect these two pipes by another pipe like this, will the water flow in this pipe? And say one more pipe like this, will the water flow in this pipe? So the water will flow in these two pipes, but there won't be any water flowing in this first pipe. We can explain this by saying that the first pipe, which is horizontal, connects two points which are in the same height, but in the second pipe and the third pipe the water will flow. So here the water will flow in this direction, and in this third pipe the water will flow in this direction. So similarly here, in this analog situation, here the current is flowing these two branches. Now suppose if I connect these two branches by a third branch like this, the current will flow in this branch if there is a potential difference between the points B and D. In the analogous situation, same height means they have the same gravitational potential. Here it's electrical potential. If the two points B and D are the same electrical potential, then there won't be any current flowing in this branch. The drop across the resistance R1 is V1, say, which is equal to VA minus VD, because the resistance R1 is connected between the nodes A and D. The resistance R1 is connected between the nodes A and D. And when the bridge is balanced, the current in this galvanometer branch is zero, so the resistances R1 and R3 are in series. And drop across the resistance R2 is V2, which is VA minus VB, because it's connected between the nodes A and B. The resistance R2 is connected between the nodes A and B. So V2, the drop across R2 is VA minus VB. The current flows from higher potential to lower potential. So V1 and V2 will be same when VA, VB and VD are same. So instead of saying that the condition for bridge balance is VB equal to VD, we can also say the condition of bridge balance is V1 equal to V2. When VB and VD are same, V1 and V2 will be same. So the condition of bridge balance we can say as V1 equal to V2. V1 is R1 divided by R1 plus R3 into E, where E is the EMF of the cell when the current in the galvanometer branch is zero. When the current in the galvanometer branch is zero, whatever current flows through resistance R1, it will flow through R3, as there is no current flowing in this branch. And we are using a standard result. If two resistances are connected in series, the drop across this one of the resistances, the value of the resistance divided by the total resistance into the total voltage drop. So V1 is R1 divided by R1 plus R3 into the total voltage drop, which is E. Similarly, V2, which is the drop across R2, when the bridge is balanced, there will be current flowing this branch. So whatever current flows through R2 will flow through R4. So the resistance R2 and R4 are in series. So drop across R2 is R2 divided by the total resistance R2 plus R4 into the total voltage drop, that is E, when the current branch is zero. So V1 equal to V2 means R1 by R1 plus R3, this one equal to R2 divided by R2 plus R4. So taking the reciprocal, you get this one. So the left hand side is 1 plus R3 by R1, and right hand side is 1 plus R4 by R2. So that is R3 by R1 should be equal to R4 by R2. So taking the reciprocal, we get R1 by R3 equal to R2 by R4. So this is the condition for bridge balance. So if the value of resistance are such that this condition is satisfied, then there won't be any current flowing this galvanometer branch. So the condition for bridge balance is R1 by R3 should be equal to R2 by R4. If the condition is satisfied, then the current in this galvanometer branch is zero. Let us consider some applications of this Wheatstone bridge principle. First is the meter bridge. It's for measuring the value of unknown resistance. And second application is potentiometer. It's for finding the EMF of a cell and its internal resistance. So first, let me consider this first application, which is a meter bridge. So this is a circuit diagram of a meter bridge. There is a long wire A to C of length 100 centimeters, which is 1 meter. That is why it's called meter bridge. And there are resistances R and S connected between the points, these two points, and S is connected between these two points. So these L-shaped elements, one here and one here, and the straight element here, are metallic strips which have got very low resistance. It's almost zero resistance, so it's a perfect conductor. And there is a galvanometer connected between the points B and D, and D is a variable point which can be moved. At this point, D is moved so that the current in this galvanometer branch is zero. So this is like Wheatstone bridge, and here is the equivalent circuit of that. So between the nodes A and B, there is a resistance R, and between the nodes P and C, resistance S, and between nodes A and D, where D is a variable point, there is a wire of length L1. So the resistance corresponding to this length is the resistance of this branch, and between D and C, there is a resistance of value corresponding to the length 100 minus L1. So like Wheatstone bridge, there are four resistances here. R and S are two resistances, and a wire of length 100 centimeters is made of two parts, L1 and 100 minus L1. So this wire of length 100 centimeters, it requires uniform resistance, and let the resistance per unit length, per unit centimeter be RCM. So the four resistances will be RS and L1 RCM and 100 minus L1 into RCM. So in the bridge spans, we use the Wheatstone bridge principle. So R by S should be equal to L1 into RCM divided by 100 minus L1 into RCM. So from this, we get this is the condition for the bridge balance. So L1 is measured using the scale here. So using this scale, we can measure this value L1. So if one of the resistance values is known, the other resistance can be calculated. So these are the meter bridge is used to find an unknown resistance. This is the second application for this Wheatstone bridge principle, which is potentiometer. So potentiometer is for measuring the EMF of a cell and also to find its internal resistance. So first, let us measure the EMF of a cell. So this is a circuit diagram. So there is a long wire here from A to C, placed in a zigzag fashion. Since the length of the wire is long, if it is kept in a zigzag fashion, then the instrument will be compact. And there are two cells of EMF E1 and E2 connected to the points 1 and 2 respectively. And galvanometer is connected between the points 3 and N1 and N2 are variable points. And these points are moved such that the current in this galvanometer branch is zero. And there is a battery of denoted by symbol B with a variable resistance here, which will drive the current in this circuit. So this is also like a Wheatstone bridge, and here I have done the equivalent circuit to make it easier to understand. It's like a Wheatstone bridge. So between the points A and 1, cell 1 is there. Between A and 2, there is cell 2 of EM of E2, and garamond is connected to point 3. And the other end of garamond is a variable point, which is either N1 or N2 or N2. And there is, between A and C, there is a long wire of uniform resistance, and there is a battery which drives the current in the circuit. So first, this point C will be connected to point 1, so the cell of EMF E1 will come into the circuit, and after that this will be opened, and point 3 and 2 will be connected by a switch, and cell 2 will come into the circuit. So for the current in the garamond to be 0, the potential at point 3 should be same as the potential at point N1. So when this current is garamond branch is 0, the potential at point 3 and point N1 are same. So that is same as saying the drop from A to 3 should be same as the drop from A to N1. So N1 is the balance point when E1 is connected, and A2 is the balance point when cell 2 is connected. So drop V to A3 is E1, which is equal to VAN1 when point 3 is connected to point 1. And drop across VAN1 is proportional to this length here. The drop from here to here is this battery voltage, which is some voltage, so, and is distributed uniformly, and this resistance is proportional to the length, so the drop from A to N1 is proportional to this length AN1. So drop VAN1 is proportional to the length AN1, which is equal to L1C. So E1 is proportional to L1, because the drop from A to 3 should be same as drop from A to N1 when the current is garamond branch is 0. That's the Wheatstone bridge principle which I am using here. So we get E1 is proportional to L1. Similarly, when the point 3 is connected to point 2, the cell 2 will come into the circuit. So drop VA to 3 is E2, which should be equal to VA2, because the bridge is balanced, and VA2 is proportional to length AA2, which is equal to L2, say. So E2 is proportional to L2. So dividing this and this equation, we get E1 by E2 as L1 by L2. L1 and L2 are measured, and if one of the cell EMF is known, the other cell EMF can be found out. So this is a EMF of an unknown cell is found. So next, let's then measure the internal resistance of a cell. So this is a circuit diagram for measuring the internal resistance. So this is the cell for which you have to find the internal resistance, and it is connected to a resistance box whose resistance value is known, and there is a key here. This is the equivalent circuit. So this is like a Wheatstone bridge only, where between A and this top of the galvanometer bridge there is cell and also a resistance box which will get connected when this key is closed, and there is a long wire between the points A and C. So in the first situation, we will open this key. So this cell of EM of E will come into the circuit, and the drop between A and the stop of this galvanometer is this EM of E, because there is no current flowing this galvanometer branch, because this point 2 is adjusted such that the bridge is balanced. So the drop from A to the top of the galvanometer will be EM of the cell. That should be equal to the drop from A to N1. So when key K2 is open, drop from A to top of galvanometer is E, which is the EM of the cell, and the corresponding null point is N1. So E should be equal to VAN1, which is proportional to the length AN1, which is equal to L1, say. Next, we close this key, and when this key is closed, again we are adjusting this thing so that there is no current flowing in this branch, but there will be a current flowing in this loop in this clockwise direction. Current will flow in this direction because of this EMF of the cell. Let that current be I. So the drop from A to the top of the galvanometer and the internal resistance of the cell is here. Its values are, that is the one we have to find out. So the So the drop from the point A to the drop of the galvanometer is E minus R divided by R plus R into E, because the resistance small r and the value of the resistance box are in series. So the drop across this is R divided by the total resistance into the total EMF. And the current will flow in this direction. So the drop from A to this top of the galvanometer is drop here, and here there will be a rise. So it is E minus the drop in that small resistance R, that is R divided by R plus R into E, which is equal to capital R divided by R plus R into E. So this potential should be equal to VA N2, because the bridge is balanced, which is proportional to the length A N2, which is equal to L2. So if you divide this and this, this one, E proportional to L1, we get R divided by R plus R equal to L2 by L1. So we are dividing this equation and this equation. So we get L1 by L2 equal to E divided by R by this one. So taking the reciprocal, we get R by R plus 1 equal to L1 by L2. From this we get the value of internal resistance R as L1 by L2 minus 1 into R. So capital R is the value of the resistance box, which is known, and L1 and L2 are measured. From this we can find the internal resistance of the cell. The two parameters which characterize the cell are its EMF and its internal resistance, which we can find using the potentiometer. So these are the two applications of Wheatstone bridge principle. Thank you.